It's Marcus Firegone here with my 12th installment of the Gran Turismo 7 Drive series, and this time with my first engine swap. This month, I'm going to be modifying a 1969 Corvette Stingray, a C3 Vette. And not any C3 Corvette, Rambo. Check out the link below for their YouTube channel. This car was custom built and I tried to duplicate it as best I could. I recently upgraded to a PlayStation 5 from a PlayStation 4, but I lost some of my data, including the video on creating this car. But I purchased the Corvette Stingray for 52,900 credits, and it has a PowerPoint rating of 500.57. With the upgrades of 160,500, it takes me to a PP rating of 655.78. And stick around for later in this video to see how much more we can spend on this car doing an engine swap and the performance rating that we can achieve with that. This is the seventh car that we've tuned and customized, and it ranks 6th overall with a PowerPoint rating of 655.78. And here are the 5 Le Mans styled cars that I've been racing. And these are the 2 bonus cars. That's a total spend so far of 21,638,923 credits. The upgrades included wide body, spoiler, rims, 3 levels of weight reduction, all the semi-racing upgrades, and soft racing tires. I created my own grid of cars, which includes the cars that we've tuned and raced earlier. And time to go racing. The Supra RZ from September just clipped us and spun out there. all right handling car, but man, it's topping out at 140 miles per hour. I just got it pinned all the way down the straight. That's one lap. I still have one car ahead of me, the C7 Corvette, the yellow car. Can't even see it, so I really gotta push it here and stay firm on the track. I can't risk losing a second. Oh man, I'm into the turf, and I hit the wall. That's not gonna help. I think I'm making up time on the corners, but I'm losing it on the straightaways with a top speed of 140. Well, there he is. He's in my sights. I'm not gonna catch him. I made a technical error. I should have slipstreamed him coming out of the last turn. And maybe not hit that wall earlier. And there you have it, 4 minutes and 16.189 seconds. That puts me at the third fastest time behind the Ferrari 365 and Ferrari 512. Now let's do an engine swap and then run the same race again and compare our times. You have to be at collector level 50 in order to do an engine swap. So one way to quickly get there is to purchase a lot of cars. So you can see here, we can put the LT5 Corvette engine from the C7 into it. That's going to cost us another $167,000. So after doing the engine swap, we have to go back and add a bunch of the semi-racing components because I guess we threw those away with the other engine. That now gives it the highest PowerPoint rating of all the other cars that I've made, with 712.63. And our total upgrade cost is $377,300, bringing the total price of the car to 430,200 credits. Now we're back to two laps of Trial Mountain and see how our time compares. I definitely feel I have more power, but the car's also trickier to handle. Oh yeah, I'm already passing the C7 Corvette. Oh man, it's maxing out again, but this time 160 miles per hour. I don't do any real tuning on these cars, so I could go back and change how the transmission ratios are and try to improve the top speed. So that's something that I could look at. Okay, kept it off the wall that time. And I've got the C7 in sights. Let's see if I can pass it before the finish line. This time I got him on the slipstream, try to get him before the line. And I did it, pulled ahead of him. Oh man, that's just the first lap. I thought I was done the race. Okay, well I got the lead coming through the end of the first lap. See if I can hold it for this lap and finished first overall. Oh man, keep it off the wall. This car's a little squirrely with this engine. can I hold him off through this straight section? He's able to obtain a higher speed than me. Yes. Four minutes and 9.023 seconds. Not bad. Well, now it's also the fastest time. Thanks for joining me. Marcus Firegone, signing off. See you next month.